Hello lovelies, the Saniora cookies are as fun to make as they are to eat. I'm Hadia from Hadias Lebanese Cuisine. Saniora is a shortbread cookie that hails from Saida, south of Lebanon. The city has a reputation for being home to some of the best Lebanese sweets, and one of the most celebrated desserts is Saniora. It is scrumptious with straightforward ingredient list: ghee, powdered sugar, and flour, that's it. They're simple cookies at their core and have a gratifying crunch that melts into a sweet and buttery tenderness in your mouth. I'm going to show you two famous variations. The same dough can deliver both plain and another Saniora with a sweet pistachio surprise inside. If you want some of each, divide the dough into two portions. But before we get started, let me focus on one thing. I would rather prefer you use a scale in measuring the dough ingredients specifically for this recipe. It is far more accurate than measuring with cups, which means you can be confident that you followed the recipe exactly right. To make the dough, place the ghee and powdered sugar in a large bowl. Mix together with a spatula. Add the flour a little at a time and start mixing with the tips of your fingers. The mixture will first crumble. Continue kneading until you have a dough of one texture. Knead for more until you have a malleable, soft texture. Alternatively, you can use your stand mixer, but I like to use my hands. Transfer to a bowl, cover with plastic wrap and refrigerate for a minimum of 30 minutes. This will guarantee that your Saniora will keep their shape and won't spread. Preheat oven to 320 Fahrenheit with a rack in the center. Line two baking trays with parchment paper. Place the raw pistachios in a food processor and pulse a few times to considerably grind them. Transfer to a bowl, add the sugar and ghee and mix well to fully incorporate. Knead well the dough again. You will notice that chilling has solidified the fat in the dough. That's okay. A few more kneading and the dough will be easy to work with. Divide the dough into two equal portions. Use half of the dough to make the pistachio filled Saniora and keep the second half to make plain Saniora. Unlike plain Saniora that needs no mold to shape it, pistachio filled Saniora gets a specific stainless steel oval mold used for shaping and forming it. I bought it back from Lebanon, specifically from Saida. Take a small handful of the dough, roughly the size of a ping pong ball. Make a hole in the center with your finger. Fill the hole with a teaspoon of the pistachio filling. Seal the hole, patching the dough together, and roll it into a ball. Transfer into the mold, pressing it lightly in to level it up with. Invert the mold and strike it a couple of times to release the cookie. You need to lightly dust the mold with flour before filling. This will facilitate the release of the pistachio filled Saniora out of the mold. When imprinting the pistachio Saniora dough with a mold, stop frequently to dust the patterns from extra flour on top. Bake in the oven for about 12 to 15 minutes. But ovens and bakeries have rotating racks that makes it possible to cook everything evenly. This is not the case in home ovens, so it's advisable to rotate your cookie sheet halfway through the baking for even cooking. Check on cookies at 12 minutes of baking. You can cook them longer if necessary. Note that cookies should not brown on top. The only way to know for sure that they are done is to roll one over and see that it's just slightly brown on the bottom. Remove from the oven and leave them to cool down completely. Now to make the plain Saniora. Take a small handful of the dough, roughly the size of a ping pong ball, roll by rubbing it with your palms. Lightly flatten and try to shape it to a rhombus by directly shaping the edges. Place on a sheet lined with parchment paper, leaving some space between one and another. Bake for about 12 to 15 minutes as mentioned in making the pistachio Saniora. The cookies should not brown on top. And the only way to know for sure that they're done is to roll one over and see that it's just slightly brown on the bottom. Remove from the oven and leave them to cool down before transferring to a serving plate. Serve with a cup of Lebanese coffee, but a fair warning, they are dangerous to keep around. You'll be snacking on them all day long. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you like our recipes, hit the subscribe button, give a thumbs up, and share it on your social media. We really appreciate your support.